Oh, what's good? What's good? It is good to be back here at Flappers. Hey, y'all look fantastic. Y'all making me nervous in there. It's hard to get up on this mic because it's hard to get in the club, and for me that's difficult because they don't think I'm old enough to drink. So it's time to ask the audience, how old do I look? Here? Shout it out.
22.
I'm 28 years old. No one believes me. Carded in New York, carded in San Francisco, carded in Los Angeles. Just this week I was carded at a Chuck E. Cheese's. Now why would you name a strip club Chuck E. Cheese's in the first place, homie? That's fake news. People want to know, Hayward, how did you get into the comedy scene? Catholic school, homie. Now I like Catholic school, and I like Sister Ursula, but it was always me thinking different. I'm always getting in trouble. What would Jesus do? George, what would Jesus do? I said, Sister Ursula. If I knew what Jesus would do, then you'd be working for me, sister. And we'd be making a couple changes up in this joint. Starting with recess at 10 a.m. and prolonged throughout the rest of the day, homie. It was pandemonium in the third grade class. A leader had been born and his name was George Hayward. Thank you, sir. I asked all the hard-hitting questions, homie. How did we get here? What is the meaning of life? And why did God invent a tree that smells like seed? And who planted that tree in my yard? I can't bring anyone over anymore. People think I'm degenerate or something. I asked all the good questions, I had all the good ideas, I just didn't know when not to say in a Catholic school, real talk. I said, Sister Ursula, did Jesus get laid? Of course not. Okay. Sister, I've got an idea. In Catholic school, we always talk about the Virgin Mary, but we never talk about the Virgin Jesus. If the church is so against us having sex, sister, then why don't they call him the Virgin Jesus? It's because the Pope doesn't want us to think, sister, that Jesus was a loser. In other words, sister, if Jesus wanted to get that pussy, then he was going to get it. And that is one of the great dimensions of our faith. Turns out that's not what you're supposed to say in Catholic school. I backed it up with logic. I said, well, sister, you were in the club with the VIP and you turned water into wine. Panties are dropping for Jesus. I said, you fed 5,000 people and you pick up the tab? Panties are dropping for Jesus, sister. I said, you roll 12 deep wherever you go like a hip-hop mo, panties are dropping for Jesus. My friends telling me, George, don't say this. It's gonna hurt you politically. But you're wrong. I said, homie, it's not gonna hurt me politically, it's gonna help me because people want to hear the truth. And Daddy Hayward is gonna give it to him. When I do that, I talk to him. That's my hashtag, remember that. See, we have to come to the comedy club because it's hard to find what's real. All this fake news, and even worse than fake news is fake advertising. Last day I was trying to relax, saw a Kia commercial with LeBron James in it, homie. Now, no disrespect. But who here believes that LeBron James drives a Kia? No disrespect. Who here believes LeBron can fit in a Kia? He can't. He's too big. As we say down south, es imposible. What we need, homie, are ads that make sense. Trojan condoms brought to you by the NBA. I buy that. Knee pads brought to you by the NFL Player Association. I handle that. Or maybe you're getting sheets, you go to the store, Bed Bath & Beyond. And you see these sheets are sponsored by the Ku Klux Klan. Whoa! Whoa! I'm black. Whoa! You have the KKK. We all have KKK. But the fact remains, You ain't never seen a Klansman with a stain on it. And that's how you know you can trust that ad, but I'm gonna leave you with something real. The greatest rapper of all time died on March 9th. His name is Biggie Smalls. Thank you.
George Thomas Aquinas, Hayward, everyone, yes! Biggie Smalls spoke to me and he said, Super Nintendo, Sega Genesis, those were their excitement.